Hello, my dear friends. I take this opportunity to wish each and every one of you joy-filled Christmas. May the newborn baby bless each one of us and protect each one of us. Today, we are starting a new series from the character of Judah. As we all know, Jesus, the King of Kings, the Prince of Peace, was born from the tribe of Judah, and therefore we always call Jesus the Lion of Judah, the stem of Jesse. Yes, my dear friends. And the character of Judah is very special. Jesus was born from the tribe of Judah, and it was not any accident. It was a perfect plan of God. And from this character, we would go for three series. And the first series we would be starting every Wednesday, you would have about 3 minutes to 5 minutes short video on the power of praise. That would be our first series. You would see why it is. And after that, we would go for the second series from the character of Judah again. It is the power of interceding. So that would be our second series. And third series from the same character of Judah would be the value of life, or we can even call it pro-life series. So all these we would start from the character of Judah as we are in the season of Christmas. My dear friends, the very name Judah, do you know what it means? It means praise the Lord. And when the Lord commanded the tribes to attack Jericho, do you remember which tribe was assigned first to reach there? It was Judah. When they were blowing the trumpet, the wall fell. The power of praise. And those days, blowing trumpet was something physical, but today it is very deep, very spiritual. It is the power of praise. And that is what we really understand. And in the Lion of Judah, we always see even David was a very powerful person, known for power of praise. All his Psalms tell that. And our Lord Jesus, who is also from the same tribe of Judah, Mother Mary, Saint Joseph, all are coming up from the Lion of Judah. They all praised God. They are all trained people to praise God. And therefore, this series on the power of praise would make us clearly what the power it has in praising God. And the second series, it is called Power of Interceding. My dear friends, if only you read whatever Judah speaks in the Bible, you would feel full of emotions and full of power, because the man full of kindness, tender heart, but courageous and God-fearing. You see, when Judah was blessed by Israel, Jacob, he was the one blessed very specially. Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and the fourth one, he was blessed very specially, already as a lion and already as the one whom your brothers will praise you and your scepter will always sustain. And that kind of blessing that he got, we already see. And the way he intercedes between the governor of Egypt, without knowing that he was his own brother, the way he intercedes, no one can minimize that character, my dear friends. He even goes for sacrificing his own life to spare his brothers. Who can do that? And he did that. And before Jacob, he says, I would get the blame if I was not able to bring back our brother. I will take the entire blame, whole of my life, the rest of my life. Who can do that? The power of interceding continues even before the governor, and Joseph could no more pretend but only reveal his identity, because when Judah speaks, only Joseph knows to cry. And my dear friends, the third series, the same character of Judah, reveals that he was a person who gave values to human life. You know, it was the same Judah when his brothers wanted to kill Joseph. You know what he said? He is our own flesh, our own blood. Why should we kill him? Instead, we can sell him to the Ishmaelites. And you remember, it was a courageous step, because Reuben only wanted to take his brother by putting him into the well. That was the most courageous step Reuben can take. But Judah took further, telling them directly, why to kill? Let us sell. And then he was giving the value for human life, my dear friends. And the same Judah, later we see that his own daughter-in-law was conceived by accident, because not knowing that it was his daughter-in-law. And when he wanted to kill her, thinking that her pregnancy was not of his cause, but once knowing the truth, how much he gave life, how much he gave importance to preserve the life, is a wonderful lesson today in this modern world. My dear friends, many people go for abortion because it is mistake many people commit. And it is shameful relation that they want to hide, and therefore they go for the abortion. Knowing the truth, knowing his own situation, he did not go for abortion. He did not kill his daughter-in-law, but went for saving the life. And from there, Jesus took the lineage. From there, the genealogy continues, my dear friends, which means it was God's plan to affirm that as a sign. Even in shamefulness, God can show his mercy if we are sincere in what we do. And there I wanted to take for the pro-life series, because this modern time demands for that. And therefore, this series, the power of praise, which would really help us to, one, who can praise God, and second, the power of interceding, because those who intercede, they are all apple of the eye for God. And third one, the series on pro-life. Yes, my dear friends, every Wednesday you would have this series for shortly for 3 to 5 minutes, and every Saturday you would also have a short homily for about 7 to 10 minutes. And then occasionally, when there are solemnities according to our church calendar, we would also have a short homily pertaining to the theme on the solemnities. And I once again take this opportunity, wish each and every one of you, all the viewers, our faithful, Merry Christmas and joy-filled New Year. God bless you all. Glory to Jesus. Ave Maria.